Let us start a new topic, fluid kinematics. Up to now, we have seen about fluid statics, and this we will see about, from now, fluid kinematics. What is kinematics? Kinematics is the study which deals with the motion. So what is fluid kinematics? The motion, the study which deals with motion of fluids is called as fluid kinematics. And this do not consider the mass of the body, mass of the fluid, and what is the force of the fluid. We do not consider in kinematics. We consider that in fluid dynamics. So a fluid flow is described by Lagrangian method and Euler-Hayes method. What are these methods? Let us know, and we differentiate these both methods. In Lagrangian method, single particle followed by an observer. Suppose a fluid consists of number of particles. A fluid consists of number of particles. If I consider a single particle and I trace the path of this, and it is something like this. If for any time t, I need to extract these properties. So these properties are defined by like this. So this s is not displacement, it is just a property. So s is a function of s naught. This s naught is of particle, and t is the time that we are considering. So, and for this particle, there will be another path. For this particle, and there will be another path. So this this Lagrangian method is described for every particle, and the combination of this particle gives us the fluid flow. In Eulerian method, properties are described by an observer at a fixed point in the fluid flow. So here there is fluid flow of these particles, and there is origin of coordinate system. Suppose say this is x, this is y, and this is z. In Eulerian method, observer is here. In this method, observer travels with the particle. If particle is here, observer will be here. If particle is here, observer will be here. But here in this case, observer looks from this origin at every point of the flow. So here there is a statement here. Let us see. The particle approaching a point possesses the properties of fluid at that particular instant of time. What is it saying is that, suppose this point, this is not a particle, that is a coordinate of the point. So that is function of space coordinate and time. So this is space coordinate, and this is not of a particle. So what that statement is saying is that if there is any particle which approaching here, and it approaches at a time t, and this has a fluid property s bar, so this particle will possess the properties of this point. So if this particle approaches here at some time t1, and it has a fluid property of s1, so at this point this particle will possess s1. If another particle approaches at t1 at this point, it also possesses s1. So the particles the properties are fixed for every point at each and every time. So the particles approaching those points will be possessing those properties. So if we look, if we compare the complexities of Lagrangian and Eulerian, it seems like Lagrangian method is quite difficult. So this is a complex method, and this one is easy to analyze. So we use the Eulerian approach. We use Eulerian method to analyze fluid kinematics. So this is the difference between Lagrangian and Eulerian method.